Welcome cluster students, welcome to my channel Academia Mentor. Once again students, could you identify this picture? What is this? Is this a doll or is this something else? This simply looks like a doll, but this is not a doll. This is our central concept of the poem, or a part of concept of the poem, Amanda. This picture seems like doll, but this is none but Rapunzel. Now you may ask me, who is Rapunzel or who was Rapunzel? Rapunzel was a fictitious character. And what is the story regarding Rapunzel? Rapunzel was captured or captivated by a witch, and she was kept in a huge tower. And what happens to Rapunzel? And due to keeping her in a long tower, no one could be able to visit her. She was all alone in the tower. And she was kept alone. But it was quite good for her, because no one was able to visit her. At the same time, one fault she used to do, or she has done it, and that is the keeping of her long hair, through the window. And that's why the witch was quite able to go upwards or to go her, holding her hair. That is the fault what Rapunzel has committed. Now, why I am saying the story of Rapunzel? Because this is the second part of the poem Amanda. In a certain moment in the poem, the main character, or the prominent character, the child Amanda, has compared herself with Rapunzel. Let's begin the poem, then it will be quite easy for you to understand the concept of Rapunzel, at the same time the comparison of Rapunzel. Okay, now move to the text. Here, I am Rapunzel. I have not a care. Life in a tower is tranquil and rare. I will certainly never lay down my bright hair. Look at it. I am Rapunzel. Now I am asking you, is she really Rapunzel in the real sense? No. Already I told you, at a certain moment in the poem, she told, I am an orphan. Is she an orphan? No. In the real sense, she is not orphan. In the same way, here, she also told, I am Rapunzel. That means, she is not Rapunzel, but she has compared herself with Rapunzel. And why she wants to be Rapunzel? Because I told you earlier, the story of Rapunzel, that Rapunzel was all alone in a tower. And earlier I also told you in the first video that Amanda always desires to be alone. She always likes to be in isolation. Now, that's why she compared herself with Rapunzel. I have not a care. Life in a tower is tranquil and rare. So she doesn't want to care for anyone. Neither for her relatives, neither for her own family members, nor for anyone. She doesn't want to care for anyone. Life in a tower is tranquil. Tranquil means quite silent one. Silent one means no... Any kind of problem will be there in her life. She will be all alone in a place. No one will be there to take care of her. No one will be there to instruct her. No one will be there to pamper her. So all these things, she always neglect all these things. The things like instruction, the things like pampering, the things like giving order every time. All these things she dislikes. And that's why she wants to be Rapunzel, and she wants to stay alone in the long tower, exactly like Rapunzel. And this kind of tranquil life, tranquil and real life what Rapunzel had, she also wanted to get it. Okay, now, I will certainly never lay down my bright hair. But the fault, but the mistake what Rapunzel used to commit, Rapunzel, I told you earlier, that Rapunzel used to commit mistake that she used to keep her hair. Look at here. Rapunzel used to keep her hair through the window. This year, she used to keep her hair through the window. She laid down her hair through the window. And that is the mistake what she has committed in the story. But here, the character Amanda doesn't want to commit this kind of mistake. She will not commit mistake that she will not keep her hair or she will not lay down her hair through the window. That anyone will be able to go through the air or you know, anyone will be able to go upstairs or go to her holding the hair of that girl. Okay, so on the whole, what she wants to express through these lines, she expressed her deep desire that the life, the tranquil and real life what Rapunzel had, she also desires to get that kind of tranquil and real life. But committing of mistake what Rapunzel had or Rapunzel committed, she doesn't want to commit this mistake, keeping up here through the window. That means the isolation or the desolation what she desires has been expressed in these lines. Okay, now move to the next stanza. Now better to discuss about the literary devices of this stanza. Allusion. What is allusion? You need to understand. Allusion means reference from. Look at here. Use of famous fairy tale character Rapunzel. Okay, here Rapunzel is the allusion. I told you allusion means reference from mythical figure, historical figure. If any historical figure or mythical figure or fictitious famous character has been taken and mentioned in the poem, that will be known as allusion. So Rapunzel is also a character which is taken from a famous fictitious story. That's why it is known as what? Allusion. Okay. Now, next literary device. Rhyming scheme I'll tell you at the end of the poem. Assonance. Look at here. Assonance is given over here. And what is assonance? Use of vowel sound. Earlier I told you E and O. These two words are repeated in this line. Will you please look at me when I am speaking to you? This is not here in this stanza, but I can say you. This is obviously in the last stanza. This is obviously in the last stanza. So when I will go through the last stanza, I will tell you the use of assonance. Okay. Now, but consonance is here. Obviously, consonance is here, and you need to understand what is consonance. Use of sound R. That means use of repetition of the consonant sound R. Repetition of the consonant sound R is being mentioned here in this line. Look at here. I have not a care. Bright hair. Look at here. Repetition of R is over here. R. So these letters are repeated in the same line again and again. And that's why it is known as consonants. And repetition is also one kind of poetic device that is also used. Amanda. So the word Amanda is also used again and again. And that's why it is also a literary device which is mentioned in the poem. Now move to the next stanza. Stop that sulking at once, Amanda. You are always so moody, Amanda. Anyone would think that I nagged at you, Amanda. Look at here. So at the end, what the mother is talking to that girl, that staying in a moody condition, that means moody condition means without caring for anyone, without saying a single word, in a exactly like a silent baby. So this kind of reaction the mother doesn't like. The mother is instructing again and again all these things. She has ordered a lot of things, but no reaction is there from the child. She has not given least reaction whether she wants to do that or not, whether she wants to follow the instruction or not. She has not given her least kind of reaction towards the mother. That's why the mother is little bit irritated, and that's why she said, "You are always so moody." you are always Sumati. Why the mother has said? Because mother has instructed lot of things again and again, but the girl has not given single kind of reaction or single kind of, you know, yes, no reaction towards that mother. And that's why the mother is, you know, considered as a moody child. Okay. Now, anyone would think that I nagged you. So, you know, this is quite common in family, because most of the time, if the parents or the guardians or you know, anyone nag at, that means, you know, scold any little child or, you know, instruct any little child again and again, the people beside the mother or the people around both these two persons, they would think that the mother is scolding at the child or nagging at the child. So, in giving instruction again and again, it proves, or it may prove, or it may be very much harmful for the child, and it may be considered by all these people who are standing over there, they may consider it as a kind of nagging. So this is not a kind of, so what the mother desires from this stranger, this is the basic concept what you need to understand. The mother desires to get what reaction from the child. The child is in a simple condition, the child is in a, you know, constant condition, stable condition. She has not given a least reaction after getting lot of instruction, ordering from the mother. She is in a stable condition. She has not changed her reaction. And that's why the mother wanted to get, you know, reaction from the child. Whether she wants to follow the instruction or not, she wants to get the answer or reply from the child. And that's why at last the mother has, you know, considered her as a kind of moody child. And on the whole, she also told her that if this kind of instruction, giving of instruction will be going on, rest of the people who are standing over there, they may consider it's a kind of nagging towards the child. Okay. Now, move to the next slide. Here it is, the literary device, what I told you earlier. Alliteration. Alliteration is being over here. Repetition of the consonant sound is over here. Stop that sulking as sound is repeated again and again. Look. Stop that sulking as sound. Look. As. These two sounds, or these two, you know, letters are repeated again and again. That's why it is known as consonants. Okay. Sorry, alliteration. Now, repetition, already I told you, repetition is also there. Repetition is also there. The word Amanda is being repeated again and again. So, throughout the whole poem, repetition is there, assonance is there, alliteration is there, consonance is there. All these poetic devices are there. But in most of the cases, the questions regarding literary devices or poetic devices may not come in your examination, but these may be fruitful for your, you know, upcoming examination in class 11th and 12th, or for your further career. Okay. Now, these are the glossary for better understanding. These are the meanings of the difficult words. Languid means relaxed, drifting means moving slowly. Okay. Pattern means making patterns, that means making of different kinds of patterns. Tranquil means calm, I told you earlier. Okay. Now, here it is the summary of the poem Amanda. The poem describes a girl named Amanda and her mother, who is nagging her for her mistakes. She is first pointed out, most probably by her mother, for beating her nails and for not sitting in the right posture. The mother also feels that Amanda sits in a very lazy manner. To this, Amanda imagines herself as a mermaid who lives a calm and relaxing life in the beautiful green sea. Further, she is nagged for not cleaning her room and shoes, and also not for doing her homework. She then imagines herself to be an orphan because she is now fed up of being watched by her parents continuously. I told you earlier, there is nothing but conversation between the mother and the child. From the one part, the mother is giving instruction, order, pampering again and again regarding every kind of activity of the child. At the same time, on the other hand, the child is totally stable in her own condition, you know, in a dumb condition. She is fully stable or in a silent condition. She has not given her any kind of reaction after getting the instruction from her mother, either regarding any kind of activity, biting of nails, eating of chocolates, or, you know, regarding any kind of things. On the other hand, the, you know, inner activities are going on. Inner activities of the mind of the child is going on. What she wants to be, sometimes she wants to be mermaid, sometimes she wants to be Rapunzel, sometimes, you know, all these things are going on. Why these things are going on in her mind? Because these are the desires what comes out, what didn't come out, but that is there. All these, you know, thinking, all these desires are there in her mind, which, you know, have not come out as a kind of expression before her mother. Okay. But all these desires are there in the mind of the child. Okay. Thank you for staying with me. If you have any kind of query, you may contact me or you may send message. Thank you for watching.